please, everyone. Okay, I only told you that if your cameras are turned off, there is no chance to get the attendance. Okay, so please keep your cameras on, all of you. The students, those who are in the class, please make sure your cameras are on. Clear? So today, July 1st, a new month, right? Right or not? July 2nd today. Eva George, any doubt?
No, sir.
First only. Okay, fine. So fantastic. So welcome back to Social Science. And this class is for geography. So already you wrote the notes, right? Related with sugarcane, oil seeds, right? Tea and coffee. Clear? And the discussion is pending from the textbook, right? There are a number of one word answers are there. You have to underline that. Clear?
We only wrote till tea.
It's not clear. Hello?
We only wrote till tea.
Okay. So explanation is pending, right? Okay. Fine. So just to take your textbook, everyone. Keep the textbook ready with you. So in every class, I'm telling you people that you should always ready with your writing materials and the textbook, right? Okay. Nasil of 10B after a long time, I think so. Absent for last 2-3 classes, right? Nasil, what happened? Not clear, your voice is not clear. Please send a message. Yeah, Lakshmi Nanda. Okay, fine. Okay, so Dominic, Shania, Simon, Delvin, Shalu, Lena, Ashna, Anthony, Shifana, Saeed, Isha. Turn on your cameras, please. Sean, Shifana, Revu, Kshetra. Okay. So, first discussion on the sugar cane. All right. So we discussed about the major cereal crops of India: wheat, rice, millets, maize. Right? All those completed. Now it is sugar cane. Okay. So please check in your notes also. If any corrections needed, you can correct that. Sugar cane is a tropical as well as a subtropical crop. Underline that. Tropical as well as subtropical. Okay, closer to the equator. Okay, it grows well in a hot and humid climate with a temperature of 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. So, temperature required or climatical condition that required for the growth of this particular crop, sugarcane, right? Temperature nearly 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius and an annual rainfall of that between 75 centimeter to 100 centimeter. 75 centimeter to 100 centimeter. Okay, underline that too. Okay, one word answers. Irrigation is required in the region of low rainfall. It can be grown on a variety of soils and need manual labor from sowing to harvesting. Okay, so specialty of this crop is, we already discussed that, it is not a carif, it is not a rabi, it is not a sevi crop, right? So, 1 year, okay, almost 1 year is necessary for the growth of this particular crop, sugarcane. Clear? Understand. So irrigation is necessary for this plant where low rainfall, the region where low rainfall availability, in those regions irrigation is necessary because this is a water intensive crop, right? Yes or no? Much water is necessary. Water is necessary for the growth of sugarcane. Okay, so underline that. And much labor. It can be grown on a variety of soils and need manual labor. Not machines, but manual, human beings. Okay. From sowing to harvesting, India is the second largest producer of sugarcane only after Brazil, right? Okay, just check it. India is the second largest producer of sugarcane after Brazil. Clear? And it is the main source of sugar, gur, kandisari, and molasses. Okay. The major sugarcane producing states are Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Bihar, Punjab, and Haryana. Underline. So what are the major products? It is sugar, jaggery, kandisari, molasses, sugar syrup. Okay. The major sugarcane producing states of India, Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Bihar, Punjab, and Haryana. Underline. So that's all about the sugar cane. So write a question there, write a short note on climatical and geographical condition that required for the growth of sugar. Done.
Climatical and
geographical conditions that are necessary for the growth of sugar. So you know all these things, sugar, right? Gar means jaggery. Jaggery and the kandasari. How is kandasari? Any idea? For sugar making process, in sugar mills they will add a number of different types of chemicals to make sugar. Okay, kandasari is basically free from that chemicals. There is a first form, I mean a raw form of sugar. Okay, so Malayalam, you know kalkandam, right? Do you know that? Okay, that's right. Okay, so the major sugar cane producing states, okay, underline: Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka. Yeah, tell me. Hello, who is this? Hello.
Karpam candida. That.
Pardon?
Karpam candida. Karpam candida.
Not clear, Vishan. Tell me. Just send a message, please. Okay. Palm. So, hello.
Palm candy. Palm candy.
Ah, from palm also we can. Okay, but we are discussing about sugar cane, right? Okay. So that is available in the market. Okay. Fine. So next one, oil seeds, even from coconut tree also. Okay. Are able to make this jaggery, coconut jaggery, palm jaggery. Okay, so oil seeds in 2016, India was second largest producer, right? Is the statement is correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yeah. In your textbook? Yes. Okay. India is the second. India was the second largest producer of groundnut in the world after China. So, what is the specialty of groundnut? Groundnut. What is the use of groundnut?
To make oil.
Definitely groundnut oil. Groundnut oil. Fantastic. Okay, so come back. So we are discussing about the oil seeds here. So first one we discussed about the groundnut here. Okay. In the ripe seed production, India was third largest producer in the world after Canada and China in 2016. Right? Okay, oil seed production. So India only after what? Third largest producer in the world after Canada and China. Right? Okay, so ripe seeds means that seeds basically that producing what we are able to what we can say we are using that to produce oil. Okay, like groundnut. Okay, so next one, different oil seeds are grown covering approximately 12% of the total cropped area in of the country. So out of 100%, 12% of land in our country we are using to cultivate groundnut, basically agricultural land, right? Okay, main oilseed producer in India are, underline, groundnut, mustard, coconut, sesamum or till, soya bean, castor seeds, cotton seeds, linseed and sunflower. These are the major oilseeds that producing in India. Okay, most of these are edible. Okay, edible in the sense consume, we are able to consume as food. Okay, edible and used as cooking mediums. Not all these oils, but some oils, okay, or most of these oils we are able to, or we can use for cook food. Okay, so we are able to use most of these oils as cooking mediums. However, some of these are also used as a raw material in the production of soap, cosmetics and ointments. Some particular types of oils we are using in the cosmetic companies, okay, to produce soap, cosmetics and ointments in the medical field also. Again, ointments, you know that, right? So it is oil is the base for all these things there. I mean soap, cosmetics and ointments. Groundnut is a kharif crop, underline, and accounts for about half of the major oil seeds produced in the country. So, groundnut production is a Okay, so that's about groundnut. Okay, so comparing with the other oil seeds production, the groundnut's production is higher in India. So groundnut is a kharif crop and accounts for about half of the major oil seeds produced in the country. Gujarat was the largest producer of groundnut. Okay, I'm right. Followed by Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so please check that in your textbook. Any corrections are there? Any differences? Please check it.
Showing Tamil Nadu for me.
Yeah, Tamil Nadu, right. So correct that. So learn from your text. Okay, nothing. So addition difference is there. So learn from your text. So data are changed. Okay, so linseed and mustard are rabi crops. Sesamum is a kharif crop in north and a rabi crop in the south India. So underline sesamum. It's a kharif crop in north India and the rabi crop in the south India, related with the climatical changes. Castor seeds is grown both as a rabi and a kharif crop. Okay, castor seeds is grown both as rabi and kharif. Okay, in it, all these seasons, these castor seeds are growing in India. Okay, so write a question. All you know that. Short note on oil seeds or explain the importance of oil seeds. Okay, I'll briefly explain about the oil seeds, like that various types of questions are there. So I want to learn that. No, nothing is unimportant in this chapter. All the different types of crops, what we are discussing so far, it is important for the examination. Okay, we don't know which question you will ask for the exam. Okay.
Sir, explain the importance of oil seeds, sir.
About the next crop. Okay, back to the textbook here. So we completed sugarcane or discussion of sugarcane and oil seeds. Now it is tea, beverage crops. Okay, tea is a beverage crop, right? Okay, so we know that tea cultivation is an example of a plantation agriculture. So basically, if you are going to the higher ranges, those regions are famous for this tea and coffee cultivation. Tea and coffee cultivation, because good climatical or what you can say geographical conditions are existing in those region. Okay, that is good for coffee and tea. Coffee and tea coffee, right? Beverage crops. So just keep that in your mind. So it is also an important beverage crop introduced in India initially by the British. One mark answer. Okay, it is introduced by the Britishers in India, basically. Clear? Okay, today. So who discovered that tea is a good one that is able to give us energy, or we are able to use that for a refreshment? What is that? Who discovered that? The British people? Indians? No, the Chinese one. Okay, the Chinese people. Today, most of the tea plantations are owned by the Indians. The tea plant grows well in tropical and subtropical climates, adorned with a deep and fertile, well-drained soil. Okay, this is a geographical condition necessary for the growth of a tea. Okay, basically growing in a tropical and subtropical climatical condition, endowed with a deep and fertile, well-drained soil. Okay, well-drained soil that should be rich in humus and organic matter. The soil should be rich with humus and organic matter. Tea bushes require warm and moist, frost-free climate all through the year. Frequent showers evenly distributed over the year ensure continuous growth of tender leaves, fresh leaves. Okay, tea is a labor-intensive industry. Okay, more workers are necessary. It will require abundant, cheap and skilled labor. Number of workers are necessary, and cheap labor in the sense of the payment for them, it is less. Okay, the payment for the workers, it is less. That's what termed cheap labor. Okay, skilled labor. Okay, the worker should be skilled. Okay, they want to know how to pluck or collect these tender leaves. Okay, you can see the pictures there. Okay, so tea is processed within the tea garden to restore its freshness. Major tea producing states are Assam, hills of Darjeeling and Jalpaiguri districts. Okay, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. Apart from these, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Meghalaya, Andhra Pradesh and Tripura are also tea producing states in the country. Okay, underline. Okay, so in 2016 India was the second largest producer of tea after China. After China, underline. So there are number of one mark answers are there. A three mark question also is there. Geographical and climatic condition that necessary for the growth of tea. Okay, and the importance of tea cultivation. What kind of labor is using? Okay, such kind of things you should learn properly. Please check in your notes. Notes. In doubt, means you can ask me now. Okay, next one. Coffee, tea, coffee. It's also a beverage crop. Coffee also a beverage crop. Indian coffee is known as known in the world for its good quality. So Indian coffee is famous for its good quality. Good quality. Underline. The Arabica variety initially brought from Yemen is produced in the country. So underline. Arabica is the variety of coffee that what we are cultivating in India. Okay. Basically that brought from Yemen, name of a country, Yemen. Okay. Is produced in the country. This variety is in great demand all over the world. Initially, its cultivation was introduced on the Baba Budan Hills, and even today, underline that, Baba Budan Hills. Okay. And even today, its cultivation is confined to the Nilagiri in Karnataka, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu. So, coffee production in India is confined. Okay. Restricted, we can say like that. In Nilagiri Hills. Okay. Basically, the stretches in Karnataka, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu. Karnataka, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu. Underline. So, basically, related with the coffee cultivation, there are a number of one mark answers there. Arabica, Yemen. Okay. Baba Budan Hills, Nilagiri Hills. The major states are like Kerala, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu. Clear. These are the most important aspects related with the coffee plantation or coffee cultivation in India. Okay. Hope that the ideas are clear for you, right? Things are clear or not? Hello? So, no problem to understand all these things there, right? So, you see, easily you are able to understand the things there. Already notes are there. Textbook reading is a compulsory one. I already told you people. Textbook reading is a compulsory one. Don't skip. Okay. Every day after the class, you should read the textbook and underline the most important points. Okay. Next one, horticulture crops. What do you mean by the term horticulture? Horticulture? Hello? No answers. You are not ready to speak. What is your trouble? Tell me, what do you mean by horticulture? Any idea? Trouble? Your voice is not clear. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Horticulture, any idea?
Fruits and
vegetables. Cultivation of fruits and vegetables, correct. Okay, back. Okay, so here, India was the second largest producer of fruits and vegetables in the world after China as per 2016. India is a producer of tropical. Oh, is my voice is clear for you? Hello?
Yes, sir.
The heavy downpour here, heavy downpour. Okay, so that's what. I'm asking. Hello? No trouble in the voice, right?
It's clear.
Okay, fine. Yeah. So India is the producer of tropical as well as temperate fruits. Underline that. Tropical as well as temperate. So near to the equator. So mangoes of Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal, underline, major mango producing states. Mangoes producing states, that is Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal. Next, orange producers. orange producing states. Nagpur, Chirapunchi, that's in Meghalaya. Then bananas of Kerala, Mysore, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu. Litchi and guava of Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. Pineapples of Meghalaya. Grapes of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Maharashtra. Apples, pears, apricots and walnuts of Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh are in great demand the world over. So, India is famous for almost all the different types of fruits. Okay, almost all the fruits are growing in India and Indian fruits are world famous for its quality. Clear? Clear? So, India we already studied in class 9 that physiographic division. Almost all the different geographical conditions are existing in our country. So, almost all the different types of crops are growing in our country. Okay, clear? So, all these points are important. One mark answers. India is an important producer of pea, cauliflower, onion, cabbage, tomato, brinjal, and potatoes. That also. Okay, in the conclusion paragraph. Okay, India is an important producer of pea, cauliflower, onion, cabbage, tomatoes, brinjal and potato. Okay, underline, please underline that too. Okay, so I will give 2 minutes for you people. Please read it. Any doubt, please just ask me first. So the tea and coffee. Please read tea and coffee. Okay, next topic for non-food crops. Okay, crops that we are cultivating to sell in the market to make money. Okay, so non-food crops. First of all, rubber, fiber crops, second one, cotton, okay, and fourth one, it is jute, okay. These are the major non-food crops, can't use as food item. So first of all, rubber, number of 1 mark answers are there for these sections, please observe it clearly. Okay, it's an equatorial crop, okay, rubber is a dash crop, equatorial crop, but under special condition, it is also growing in tropical and subtropical areas, okay. So basically it is growing in the or growing near to the equator, equatorial one, but in some special conditions it will grow in the tropical and subtropical areas also. It requires moist and humid climate with rainfall or more than 200 centimeter and a temperature about 25 degrees Celsius. So we know that Kerala is famous for its rubber production, okay, because this climatical condition is existing in our state. Rubber is an important industrial raw material. It is mainly grown in Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, and Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Garo Hills of Meghalaya. Underline that. So major rubber producing states. And you can see here, moist and humid climatical condition is necessary for the growth of rubber. Okay. And more than 200 centimeters of rainfall in 1 year and a temperature about 25 degrees Celsius also necessary for the growth of rubber. Okay. So underline that question, you know that. Okay. Next one, fiber crops. The major fiber crops of India. Cotton, jute, hemp, or natural silk are the 4 major fiber crops grown in India. The first 3 are derived from the crops grown in the soil, like cotton, jute, and hemp that is growing in the soil. Okay. Or from the plants. Next one, the latter is obtained from cocoons of the silkworm, that is silk, right? Silkworm. Put on green leaves, especially mulberry. So mulberry bushes is basically using to rear this silkworms there. Rearing of silkworm for the production of silk fiber is known as sericulture. Underline that, sericulture. Sericulture, rearing of silkworms for the production of silk. Okay, that activity or that process is termed as sericulture, production of silk from the silkworm. Okay, underline that. So 1 mark, 1 mark answers are here and entirely about fiber crops. Next 2 different fiber crops, one is cotton, the other is jute. Both are important for the examination. Okay, so next one, cotton. We are going to discuss about cotton. India is believed to be the original homeland of cotton plant. 1 mark answer. Original homeland of cotton plant, that is India. Cotton is one of the main raw material for cotton textile industry. The most important raw material that using in the cotton textile industry is cotton, raw cotton. Okay. In 2016, India was second largest producer of cotton after China. Cotton grows well in drier parts of the black cotton soil. Underline that, drier part of the black cotton soil of the Deccan Plateau. Okay. Basically Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, okay, Telangana, this is the Kambaitu region. It requires a high temperature. So, cotton require high temperature, light rainfall or irrigation, not much water, light rainfall or irrigation only necessary for the growth. 210 frost-free days and bright sunshine for its growth. Underline that all. Okay, climatic condition. So you can see the cotton cultivation on picture. The cotton balls are present in this picture. Cotton balls, right? Okay, underline all those things that we discussed so far. It's a kharif crop. Next one, it's a kharif crop, winter one. And it requires 6 to 8 months of mature, 8 months to mature. Major cotton producing states are, underline, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Punjab, Haryana, and Uttar Pradesh. Underline that. It's a kharif crop and it needs nearly 8 months to mature. But today we know that the way they are using different types of seeds. Okay, so BT cotton, within a short time it will give the results. Okay, so cotton. Next one, it is jute. It is known as the golden fiber. Another one mark answer. Jute is known as the golden fiber, underline. And the jute grows well on well-drained fertile soils in the floodplain where soil are renewed every year. So basically jute will grow near to the rivers there, in the river banks. Okay, what happens to Hari? Is there raining? No electricity? Okay, fine. So come back. So it is a golden fiber and basically growing in the banks of the rivers. Okay, basically not in South India. North. Okay. Jute grows well on well-drained fertile soil. Okay. Alluvial soil basically. In the flood plains where soil are renewed every year. So because of the flood every year, okay, new layers of alluvium we are able to find in the river banks of northern India. Some special rivers are there basically in West Bengal. A high temperature is required during the time of the growth. West Bengal, Bihar, Assam, Odisha and Meghalaya are the major jute producing states. Underline. It is used in the making of gunny bags. You know that, gunny bags, right? Basically for rice. Okay, the basic packing rice. In the PDA shops, we know that, ration shops. Okay, they are using lots of gunny bags. Clear. So major jute producing state. It is used, used in making gunny bags, mats, ropes, yarn, carpets, and other artifacts. Okay, clear? Underline. Due to its high cost, it is losing market to synthetic fibers and packing materials, particularly the nylon. Okay, today, the production of jute is limited in our country. At the same time, the cost of jute is very high. You want to purchase a gunny bag from some shops, they will ask us for 30 rupees or 35 rupees or something like that. Okay, minimum 25 rupees they will ask for a bag, gunny bag. So it is very costly. At the same time, today, because of technology, we are using number of other materials. Basically, we can see here, synthetic fibers are there, like nylon. Okay, nylon bags are available, right? For packing, they're using nylon bags instead of this gunny bag. So market of this jute is declined or declining day by day. Okay, so just read the fiber crops, 2 minutes for you. Just read, any doubts means you can ask to the class. Check here, the next topic for we people it is technological and institutional reforms. Technological and institutional reforms there. So, before starting this topic, you want to understand some particular things there. Basically, without the help of the government, it is very difficult to practice agriculture, right? Clear or not? Impossible. And at the same time, today we know that the pressure on land is increasing. Okay, pressure on land increasing because the population is increasing. Okay, so we want to use the modern technologies to produce more and more food grains, right? Now, Nir Krishna, what are the modern technologies? Tell me now, Nir. What are the modern technologies we are using to produce more goods, more agriculture products? What are they?
HYV seed.
Ah, yes, it. Okay, it is correct. Okay, high yielding variety of seeds we want. Clear? Okay, and inputs like chemical. Okay, chemical inputs basically we are using to produce more food grains. Clear? Understand? And at the same time, insecticides, pesticides also. Okay, irrigation. Okay, different types of irrigation methods we are following today. At the same time, science is also helpful to increase the agricultural production. Okay, for they are basically creating new varieties of seeds, right? New variety of seeds. Those seeds are able to fight against the pests. Okay, and at the same time, the climatic changes, drought. Okay, clear or not? So we want that kind of seeds to produce more food grains. Clear? Okay, so science and technology is helpful for producing more food grains. Not only science and technology, the same time the policies of the government. Okay, institutional reforms also necessary. So government basically helping the farmers in different ways. Okay, do you know what are the ways the government is using to or used to help the farmers? What are the ways the government helping the farmers? An idea?
Providing seeds.
Pardon, yeah, providing seeds for a subsidized price. Subsidized price in the means the share of the amount will or price of the seed will pay by the government. Subsidized price. Okay, not only seeds, the farmers can purchase seeds, fertilizers, insecticides or pesticides or even machineries including the tractor, combined harvester for a subsidized price. Okay, clear? Because the government also wanted to improve the agricultural production in the country to attain food security. Attain a food security. So a part of the amount will pay by the government. It's called to be subsidized. Clear? Understand? So we discussed about the importance of technology in agricultural production and the institutional reforms. So the reforms or the activities of the government to improve the agricultural production in the country. Okay. Clear? What happened, Eva? Any doubt? No. So have you heard about Kisan Credit Card? Kisan Credit Card? Kisan Credit Card. It's a credit system for the farmers. Clear or not? Okay, so government providing loans for the farmers through nationalized banks for a low rate of interest. Low rate of interest of a nominal rate of interest. Is that clear? Okay, that also termed as an institutional reform. Institutional reform. Or you heard about, tell me.
Once more, can you repeat it?
Kisan Credit Card. Kisan Credit Card. Kisan Credit Card. Who is a Kisan? Means a farmer. It's a Hindi term, farmer, right? Credit means what loans there, right? So, like a credit card. Kisan Credit Cards are there. Basically, the farmers can get loan from the nationalized bank for a nominal interest. Nominal interest. Okay. So, it's a time to wind up the session. We will continue in the next class. Okay. So, please read the textbook thoroughly and then learn the things well. Number one mark answers are there. If you are not reading that, okay, no chance to understand and no chance to reproduce that in the examination. So please do that. Okay, everyone. Thank you.
Thanks.